Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14.5 Beta 1 has been out for a few days, and then Apple re-released it as 14.5 Beta 1 with a new build number. They didn't give it a different name, but we just called it re-release. And then also the same day they released iOS 14.5 Public Beta 1. And so I wanted to talk about a few new features that I didn't mention in the previous video, as well as the overall experience. I've been using it full time on my iPhone 12 Pro Max. I also have it on the iPhone 11 here, as well as the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020, which I use full time when I'm not editing videos. So the overall experience is pretty good, and we'll talk about your experience as well, based off the YouTube community poll, where there's 17,000 votes at the time of recording this video and 193 comments, of which I used to kind of figure out what's going on with this particular update. So when I talk about issues that this is having, it's based on that. But first, let's go over the new features. And the first one has to do with Find My. If you're using Siri to activate Find My or find someone with Siri, it actually has a slightly changed interface. So if I hold down the power sleep wake button, you can also use the word hey in front of it to activate it. But let's go ahead and try this. Find Zach Zollo. And you'll see it pops up the location fairly quickly, and there's the new interface, and it tells me where he's located. And so it's been updated, it looks a little bit different, and they've just made that slight change. Now, another thing they've changed is some people are getting a new splash screen or display screen. If we go into settings and then you open up screen time, you can see there's a new splash screen and it just tells you about it. Weekly reports, downtime and app limits, content and privacy restrictions, as well as screen time passcode. Now they had this before, but it's changed slightly. Now, other than that, there is one more small feature that may be coming in the future that's mentioned in the code. And that has to do with the potential to edit maybe a note in the future where we can't do it now. So Steve Moser, if you've been following along, one of my friends here, you can follow him on Twitter, says, I wonder if there are any new note attachment editing features in the pipeline. Editing this attachment is not supported on this device is what it's showing in the code. To edit it, upgrade to the latest version of. And he said it was seen in both beta 1 of iOS 14.5 and macOS 11.3 beta 1. So there should be some new updates with that maybe in the future. And as these beta versions progress, of course, we usually get a few more features. Now, as far as the overall experience, well, my experience has been okay. Actually, I still have that sort of app stutter when you open an app up and close it. Sometimes it will just stutter when it closes. So it could be anything from podcasts to music to Safari. It doesn't really matter what I'm opening, but it just seems to stutter from time to time. So if we go into Spotify, for example, swipe up, sometimes it will just stutter when you go back out. So if you swipe up, it has this little jitter to it. And that hasn't been fixed. It usually takes 1 to 2 days to show back up though, and it's shown back up. Also, I've had it freeze up on me when I was in settings. So I was in settings, it completely froze. I wasn't able to do anything. I had to actually close out of settings like this, go back in, then I could use it again. It did free itself up a little bit later on its own. If you just left it, it would do that, but it has locked up a couple times for me. Also, I've had some issues with these notification bubbles. So you'll see here the notification says 14 for Twitter. It works fine for that, but on messages, it seems that it's not clearing itself regularly. Sometimes it will give me a few numbers there, and then I'll go into messages, I won't have anything new, and then they don't go away. It's kind of a pain, but I've seen that. Also, if we go into messages, within messages, they've now grayed out the check mark when you're typing or texting to someone. So if I say hello, this little icon with the arrow sometimes will be grayed out. And sometimes I can't press on it even after I've typed. So for whatever reason, sometimes that doesn't show up properly and it wasn't working for me. Then it would work after I type the next message. So I'm not sure what's going on with that, but I've seen that bug as well. And so those are the bugs I've had. Actually, with the iPad, I've had no bugs whatsoever, but we'll talk about battery life a little bit later. But the issues you're having, there's a few that are noted, and the number one thing is lag. So not only the stutter that I mentioned when you're trying to swipe out of an app or things like that, everyone's mentioning that for the most part. Also, others are just saying that there's lag and stutter and occasional app crashes. So maybe you're in music or maybe you're in Spotify. It could just crash. I haven't experienced that myself, but quite a few of you have seen those apps crash. People are saying, again, freezing and mostly just lag in general. So those things have been seen throughout this update. Of course, it is an early beta. I expect those sort of things. I expect crashes, but people are seeing them more than you would with iOS 14.4, for example. Of course, there's that green tint issue, which hasn't gone away yet. Apple has not resolved it. Hopefully they will in a future update, but right now the green tint issue is still there. But when it's not freezing or lagging, performance in general is fine and everything's smooth, but then you'll get those occasional stutters and lag and it just won't perform like you would expect. Sometimes it's great, sometimes it's not. A reboot does tend to help that. I did have to reboot this. And the issues I was having with location with the Tesla app, for example, it uses location and Bluetooth to unlock my car. Those Bluetooth issues for me have been fixed. I'm not sure they have for everyone else. Also, the final thing I wanted to point out in this update is if you go into your settings with iOS 14.4, they gave you the option for sound and haptics where you could more easily sort of set it up for headphone safety to recognize what actual devices it was using. However, that's gone in this update. So if you go to Bluetooth and then we go to my car, for example, I can no longer categorize that it's audio from a vehicle. It's just not there. So they took this out in this version. It's a beta, so maybe they'll put it in a little bit later, but right now that's gone and they should bring it back, I would hope, since it was a major feature of the last one. So those are the major issues I'm having with this update. Of course, it's a beta. So if you're having issues, make sure you submit that in feedback, but that's definitely something that you should consider. Also, let's take a look at battery life. So if we go into settings, we'll go down to battery health. It's at 100%. And we'll go back over to the last 10 days. And if we look at maybe yesterday, or 2 days ago, we'll look at yesterday first, I had 4 hours and 4 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 34 minutes of screen off time, and I used a little bit over 50% of my battery. The day before that, about the same amount of usage, 4 hours and 17 minutes, 3 hours and 51 minutes of screen off time. And so you can see that it actually improved. This is the date from where we've had the re-release of iOS 14.5 beta 1 with a new build. Battery seems to have increased to at least 9 hours of screen on time if I was to use this until we reach 100% usage. So by the end of the day, I've got 50%, but the same is not true for my iPad. It seems the battery issues have returned with this beta, but again, it's a beta, so I can deal with that. But if we go to settings, we'll go to battery, and I had to charge it this afternoon. You'll see it was last charged at 3:15 p.m., but if we look over the last 10 days, maybe yesterday, I used it for 24 minutes with 1 hour and 12 minutes of screen off time. The day before, I used it for about 4 hours, and I was down to 10% battery life after this usage. So between the update for this version and then using it and not using it, I used it 4 hours, and it used my entire battery. So there's definitely an issue with standby time on the iPad, it seems. And again, it's a beta, but I'll report it and then hopefully they'll fix it when it's finally released. Now, as far as iOS 14.4, quite a few people are saying they're having issues. Battery life is improved, like I mentioned in the previous version of this video last Sunday when I talked about iOS 14.4. 71% of you said that there was no issues. You were seeing better battery life or better or the same battery life as iOS 14.3. But again, there's definitely people having issues with it. And as the update goes on, I expect there to be more issues. So there's still some issues. No version is perfect, but Apple is still working on it. And that leads me to iOS 14.4.1 maybe, or maybe we'll wait a few weeks and see 14.5. With 14.4, we only had two betas and then they released it to the public, which is very unusual. Normally you would have a minor update and then a major update later on. But it seems like we could either see 14.5 after beta 2 in a few weeks, or we could see a 14.4.1 to address the issue with green tint. And the reason I'm looking for a public release is Apple stopped signing iOS 14.3. And anytime you have 14.3 unsigned, for example, or any version that's only leaving one public release, so you can't downgrade, usually within 2 weeks or so, you'll have a public release. So I would look for something fairly soon. Could be this week, more likely the following week, but either way, I'll keep you updated as soon as I know. I think the betas currently are on a 2 week cycle, especially since we've only had this version for a few days. So I wouldn't necessarily expect a beta this week. I would wait for the beta maybe the following week. And that leads me to, should you install iOS 14.5 beta 1? Well, I would say if you're a beta tester and you know what you're getting into, then sure, but this has enough issues with lag and freezing that I would probably hold off and see how it is with beta 2. I think that's why Apple delayed public beta 1, re-released beta 1, and then released the public version, because there were so many issues. So there's definitely issues. Apple's working on it. And of course, we'll continue to submit feedback so they fix it. Now, before we take a look at the YouTube community poll, here are the statistics based off the comments you left on the community poll. So battery life, these are just mentions of these words. So battery life, lag, freezing, some phones heating up, only four or so people mentioned that, and some apps crashing, quite a few of that, and quite a few people with lag. Now, here are all the devices people are using. Not so many with the 6S this time around. And it seems like the iPhone 11 and the 12 Pro Max are the most popular right now. That seems to be the most popular currently that people are using, at least commenting on this poll. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at the community poll. Now, like I said earlier, well, it was 17,000 votes. Now it's 18,000 by the time I've recorded to this part of the video. So I really appreciate everyone that's voted. And you can see 17% of you said that it was great, 3% said it was terrible, 7% are still having some bugs, 63% of you have not updated, and 10% are using Android. And I know a lot of people say, why are you including Android? And it's generally because, well, 10% are using Android, but still enjoy these videos. So I always appreciate anyone voting, but I would like to refine these even more than we have now. And if you have an idea, let me know the top five things in the comments below that you would like to see in the next poll. And hopefully if we can get a consensus, maybe we'll use those instead. So put those in the comments below. Now let's take a look at some of the comments. There's 193 at the time of this video. And well, let's go back here and we'll sort them by newest first. And you can see here, the first person says, nameless user, says my battery health is 3% lower just with this update, 89% dropped to 86. I don't know if this is bug, but I didn't like it. I use an iPhone 11 Pro. And like I've said before, many times, the health is not affected by the update. The update is just rechecking. Now that the OS has been freshly installed, it's checking the physical battery health based off statistics that are stored within some files within your phone. And it's just giving you your battery health overall. So it's just telling you the physical capability of your battery based off a number. Now, I think Apple does delay this a little bit when they actually install an update versus if you don't install an update. So I don't know what the time frame is where it refreshes your battery health number, your battery number, but it's just something that it rechecks every time you install an update, which it will check right then and then update the number at that point. So it's not the update causing it is what I'm getting to. It's more that it's just rechecking it. Brian Zinzer says, on my iPhone XS Max, running great, battery seemed to go down a bit faster than normal, but still lasted all day. Matthew McDonald said, I'm on my 8 Plus, no problems here. Vasil says, hi Aaron, as I vote is it's okay, but have some bugs. Wi-Fi shortcuts isn't working properly. Battery life on standby 11 Pro Max is draining, but has one improvement. It's charging more correctly with MagSafe Duo. No more stutter. I can't install this one on my main phone. Respect. And thanks for commenting. Jeremy DeBose says 12 Pro Max and 2018 iPad Pro. Great so far. iPhone is getting 11 plus hours of screen on time. The multitasking return home lag seems to be gone so far. Being able to finally use Face ID with a mask on is a lifesaver. So far, so good. Vin Dusty says I'm having 4G connectivity issues. Other than that, it's great. iPhone 11 Pro Max. Jiwantha says, I have an iPhone 11 and it's been okay. Only issue that at autofill does not work. Other than that, it's perfect. Thulani Nala says, running the public beta on my iPhone 11 Pro and a couple apps have lagged a bit when opening up and battery appears to be draining a little faster. Apart from that, and for the most part, it is great and stable so far. Joseph Robinson says, good battery, but my watch seems to die faster now with S4 cellular. Noah Messer says, for the most part, it is good. I've been having issues with AirDrop where I send an attachment to another device and it will take a long time and eventually it will say it failed. The green tint issue is still present. I also found a bug where if you tap on the legal and regulatory tab in settings, it will crash the settings application. I did send feedback to Apple on all of these bugs. On the other hand, performance and battery life are good. And so let's go ahead and test that. So we'll go home, go to settings, go to general, scroll down to legal and regulatory, and it definitely crashes. We'll try it one more time, legal and regulatory, and it's crashing. So again, we need to submit those to feedback, but that's interesting. I hadn't seen that before. I'll read two more. Mohammed says, I have crashes on my iPhone 8 and battery percentage glitch too. Pikachu says, I use iOS 14.5 on both my iPhone 10 and 12 Pro. On my iPhone 10, Apple's native podcast app has a bug where it would open and continue resuming play of the latest podcast on the Up Next playlist for a few seconds, and then the app would crash. On my iPhone 12 Pro, one of my banking apps wouldn't even open. Other than each of these bugs on each phone, everything else has run smoothly. And so there are some apps that still won't open. For me, the PlayStation app won't open. And so there's definitely some bugs with it. So that's it for iOS 14.5 Beta 1 and iOS 14.5 Public Beta 1. Of course, like I said, expect an update. It may be a week or so away at this point. So maybe we'll see something this week. And if we do, I'll keep you updated. Again, if you wouldn't mind making a little list of those votes that you think would be best for the YouTube community poll, I'd love to see what you have there. Of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.